Animal world is truly wonderful. Let's go on a journey to explore them. The black stork is a large bird in the stork family Cicinidae. It was first described by Carl Linnaeus in the 10th edition of his Systema Naturae. The adult black stork has mainly black plumage, with white underparts, long red legs, and a long pointed red beak. A widespread but uncommon species, it breeds in scattered locations across Europe and east across the Palearctic to the Pacific Ocean. It is a long-distance migrant, with European populations wintering in tropical sub-Saharan Africa and Asian populations in the Indian subcontinent. When migrating between Europe and Africa, it avoids crossing the Mediterranean Sea and deters via the Levant in the east or the Strait of Gibraltar in the west. An isolated, non-migratory population occurs in southern Africa. Unlike the closely related white stork, the black stork is a shy and wary species. It is seen singly or in pairs, usually in marshy areas, rivers or inland waters. It feeds on amphibians, small fish and insects, generally wading slowly in shallow water stalking its prey. Breeding pairs usually build nests in large forest trees, most commonly deciduous but also coniferous, which can be seen from long distances, as well as on large boulders, or under overhanging ledges in mountainous areas. The female lays 2 to 5 grayish-white eggs, which become soiled over time in the nest. Incubation takes 32 to 38 days, with both sexes sharing duties, and fledging takes 60 to 71 days. The black stork is considered to be a species of least concern by the International Union for Conservation of Nature, but its actual status is uncertain. Despite its large range, it is nowhere abundant, and it appears to be declining in parts of its range, such as in India, China, and parts of Western Europe, though increasing in others such as the Iberian Peninsula. Various conservation measures have been taken for the black stork, like the Conservation Action Plan for African Black Storks by Wetlands International. It is also protected under the African Eurasian Waterbird Agreement and the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora. The black stork is a large bird. It bears some resemblance to Abdom's stork, which can be distinguished by its much smaller build, predominantly green bill, legs and feet, and white rump and lower back. The plumage is black with a purplish-green sheen, except for the white lower breast, belly, armpits, axillaries, and undertail coverts. The breast feathers are long and shaggy, forming a ruff which is used in some courtship displays. The black stork has brown irises and bare red skin around its eyes. The sexes are identical in appearance, except that males are larger than females on average. Molting takes place in spring, with the iridescent sheen brighter in new plumage. It walks slowly and steadily on the ground, and like all storks, it flies with its neck outstretched. The juvenile resembles the adult in plumage, but the areas corresponding to the adult black feathers are browner and less glossy. The scapulars, wing and upper tail coverts have pale tips. The legs, bill and bare skin around the eyes are grayish-green. It could possibly be confused with the juvenile yellow-billed stork, but the latter has paler wings and mantle, a longer bill, and white under the wings. A wary species, the black stork avoids contact with people. It is generally found alone or in pairs, or in flocks of up to 100 birds when migrating or during winter. The black stork breeds between April and May in the Northern Hemisphere, with eggs usually laid in late April. In Southern Africa, breeding takes place in the months between September and March, possibly to take advantage of abundant water prey rendered easier to catch as the rivers dry up and recede, from April and May in Zimbabwe, Botswana and Northern South Africa, and as late as July further south. The black stork mainly eats fish, including small cyprinids, pikes, roaches, eels, buds, perches, burbots, sticklebacks and muddy loaches. It may feed on amphibians, small reptiles, crabs, mammals and birds and invertebrates such as snails, mollusks, earthworms, and insects like water beetles and their larvae. I just hope it was a marvelous journey. Thank you for your interest in wildlife. See you pretty soon. Till then, take care and be safe.